Holograms will soon become part of our everyday life. They are no longer just science fiction. Imagine seeing them when you go shopping, visit museums, or watch shows at the theater. And that's just a start. Think about joining a meeting as a 3D hologram where people feel like you are actually there, or playing video games surrounded by a holographic world, making you feel like you are really inside action. I'm Katsuya Tanaka, a researcher in Germany studying the science of light. Today we are exploring how holograms work, the technology behind them, and how they are transforming our ways of connecting, learning, and experiencing the world. Keep watching, there's so much to uncover. A hologram isn't just a flat picture or a video. Unlike a regular photo, which only shows one view, a hologram is 3D. It captures an object from every angle. So as you move, the hologram changes too. This gives it that unique, lifelike appearance. Holograms record more than just colors and shapes. They record how light bounces off an object from all directions, which gives them their realistic floating look. Holograms are made using lasers. Lasers are special because they produce their steady, focused light. To make a hologram, the laser beam is split into two parts. One part, called the object beam, shines directly onto the object we want to capture, picking up all its details, its shape, its texture, and even small surface details. The other part, called the reference beam, goes straight to a special recording surface without touching the object. When the object beam and reference beam meet on the surface, they create a unique pattern called an interference pattern. This pattern holds all the information about how light interacts with the object, almost like a map of light. When we shine light on this pattern later, it brings the object back to life, creating the hologram we see. This interference pattern is what gives holograms their depth and makes them look real. Not all holograms are made the same way. Different types are used for different purposes. Transmission holograms, for example, need to be lit from behind to display the image. These are often used in scientific displays. Then there are reflection holograms, which reflect light and can be seen in regular lighting. These are common on credit cards or ID cards because they are hard to copy, making them great for security. We also have digital holograms, which are created and displayed using computers. Digital holograms are unique because they don't need a physical object to create the image. So why do holograms look 3D? It comes down to the way light interacts with our eyes. When we look at a real object, light bounces off it and reaches each eye at slightly different angles, giving us depth perception. A hologram recreates this effect by recording and replaying these light angles. This is why a hologram looks real from every angle, unlike 3D movies or VR, which only trick our eyes into seeing depth. Holograms are already used in some exciting ways. In medicine, for example, holograms allow doctors to see organs in 3D, helping them plan surgeries with greater precision. Archaeologists use holograms to preserve and study delicate artifacts without risking damage to the originals. Holograms are also valuable for data storage, holding much more information than traditional methods by using 3D space. And of course, they add a layer of security on credit cards, passports, and other ID cards. The potential for holograms in the future is thrilling. Imagine using holograms for virtual meetings, creating 3D images of people in real time. You could have a conversation with someone as if they were in the room, making communication more personal and engaging. This could make remote work feel more connected and realistic. In entertainment, holograms could completely change the way we experience media. Imagine concerts where performers appear as holograms, or movies that place viewers right inside action. Some artists are already using holograms for performances, and as the technology improves, these displays could become more realistic and common. In education, holograms could transform the way we learn. Imagine students exploring a 3D model of the solar system that they can actually walk around. Holograms can make learning more hands-on and interactive. This could be useful in schools and in professional training, where medical students could practice on holograms of organs, building their skills before working with actual patients. Holograms could also change the way we shop. Imagine trying on clothes virtually or examining a product in 3D before buying it. This could make online shopping feel more like being in the store, helping customers see what they are getting. Holograms could even allow us to preview products from all angles, making purchases more reliable. Right now, creating true 3D holograms is still a bit difficult and expensive. High-quality holograms require very precise control of light and extremely stable environments to work well. Even though we have made huge progress, our current technology can't yet create fully realistic 3D holograms that work perfectly in all settings. Researchers are exploring new materials and techniques to solve these challenges. The hope is that one day holograms could be smaller, more affordable, and easy to use. We might even see holograms on our phones or as wearable tech, like a portable hologram projector you could carry in your pocket. But we are still working to get there. Holograms could transform how we live, learn, and connect. Imagine a world where holograms replace screens. Instead of looking at the phone or computer, you could have holograms display information in 3D right in front of you. Holograms might also enhance safety in cars, projecting directions or alerts onto the windshield, helping drivers stay focused on the road. Holograms are an amazing technology that combines science and creativity to make 3D experiences feel almost real. From changing how we communicate to bringing new ways of learning, holograms have huge potential. Thanks for joining me on this journey into the science of holograms. I hope this gave you a clear view of how they work and the exciting possibilities ahead. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time. Bye.